an aged dwarf. You can...
Sit, please. Thank you for joining us, Watcher.
A pale.
She's your brush with the divine. Does everything appear to be in order? Good.
The dwarf.
Tell me, do you remember when we last met? And though you could have broke, you had neither being, though Aeth, you and he are still connected. He has chosen a body made of living Audra, perfused with the power of thousands of souls, including yours. Taking a physical form in Aeora is fraught with peril. Most mortal minds and bodies are incapable of containing divine power. It can lead to problems, as Aeth has learned not long ago.
Her armored hand gingerly places a card sideways on the table. It features a man with a burst of light instead of a head.
Unfortunate. This will prove much more difficult without someone of your unique talents and circumstances.
She raises her dwarf knots, the supernaturally wide smile returning to his face. He gestures for you to follow him. No sooner has Barith spoken than you feel yourself dissolve. It is not an unpleasant sensation. Something between falling asleep and drifting on a warm current. Your essence is pulled through the Audra, where it mingles with the stuff of thousands of other souls. Your thoughts, your memories, even your identity as the Watcher, fade like a dream. Eventually, your soul reforms and finds its way into a small, crawling thing of fur and claws. You know the world by sound and scent, as food and danger. The concerns of gods and nations are beyond you. It is a simple and satisfactory existence, though your mind can conceive of no other. Whether it is a long one will depend upon the Watcher Barith chooses in your stead. An aged dwarf, you can see.
Sit, please. Thank you for joining us.
A pale.
She's your brush with it. Does everything appear to be in order? Good.
The dwarfs
tell me, do you remember? And though you could have broke,
she delicate.
You had neither be, though Aeth, you and he are still connected. He has chosen a body made of living Audra, perfused with the power of thousands of souls, including yours. No. But neither is your body truly alive.
She delicately places a card upright on the table. The art depicts souls flowing out of a pillar of Audra.
Did you care for the souls of the Deerwood who clung to you as they stumbled blindly through the in-between? You are a beacon to all of the Lost Watcher. Your soul gleams as brightly to them as Audra itself.
For a moment, there is a glint in the blackness of her eyes. A flash of wondrous...
Those who have fallen in Aethys's wake are trapped inside him still. If you will not help them, who will? Of course, if that doesn't convince you, I can always return you to the wheel and find someone else to pursue him. Good. Before you return to Aeora as my herald, when you can picture your own face, the Beyond will lead you back to your own kind, to the world.
Thank you. quick and quiet. Just say the word. I'll lead the way.
Onward!
Not a sound.
What can I do? I'm flattered.
Kill them all!
A blade in the dark.
Well?
Finish them!
To whispers and shatten.
Let's go!
Quietly.
I'll teach you a lesson!
Easy does it.
Right here.
Go forth now, Watcher, as my herald. Know that I do not give you this title lightly. When the time comes, you will have the power to reveal the souls that cling to you. To open the gateway from the in-between to the waking world. Find Aethys. Learn his plans.
With a quick gesture of her hand, you've...
A child.
The dwarf nods. The creases of the dwarf's face tighten into a smile as he gives you a courteous nod. The return to your body feels like waking after Adair watches over your body with a glazed...
No, there's no way. How are you feeling? Me? I'm not you. Don't worry. It'll all come back. Ah, see? You remember. Anyway, you didn't answer my question. How are you feeling? Alive's a big improvement.
I hate to cast a pall over your recovery, but I'm afraid I have some bad news.
The voice echoes.
Hadnua has been... It is a... I know not how, but it seems he has retained a piece of your soul.
How could you know all that? You've been faking on us.
He pokes at your shoulder with one finger.
Misfortune!
And
pirates!
I know this is asking a lot, but you better arm yourself and get on deck. Should be some gear in there.
He indicates a near...
All right, now make some use of it.
Pirates of Deadfire are notorious. I suggest you deal with them quickly.
We are. I'll be taking.
Well, at least he had.
I am a gentleman of giver up easy.
and I'll see you get a swift death. It'll be bloody and agonizing, sure. But at least it'd be quick. Why complicate this with a quarrel? I see, I want, I take. It's as simple. Me and my mates will be helping ourselves to your ship. There's no need to see her sunk by the storms. Or my culverins. Listen up, mates. I'm off to spear me play with a crew.
You heard, Benwith! Ah!
Defend the ship!
Thank you.